Internet. I'm too lazy to regularly back up my most important data, so I thought I let the computer do this for me. I will use the command line options of WinRAR and the Windows scheduling. Here I prepared a little script. The first line I just copied from the internet, this will prepare the actual the date from today in the format year, month, day. Here I'm calling WinRAR over the command line, and when I ask nicely, WinRAR also tells me what commands it understands. So let's see what I did here. Here the A means I'm adding the files to an archive. The minus R means it will go recursively through all subfolders, and the minus M5, so your version is probably in English, minus in German, so the M5 means it's a method of compression, and I thought, well, when I'm backupping, let's take the maximum compression. So here I wrote which file it shall create for me. Here is where I include the date into the file name. I tell it to put it on my desktop because there are no files on my desktop. And if there is something, it annoys me and I need to take care of that. So for instance, if there's a file I need to backup, then I need to copy somewhere else and I will do this. Here I have a space in the folder name. That's why I need to put the whole name into quotations. Of course, if I would have another drive in my computer, I could also just back up my file there. So it depends on what you want to do. And here is the folder I like to back up. It's my documents folder, and again it has a space in the name, so I need the quotation. So now the script is prepared and I need to create a new task. I need to call it regularly. I think for you it's called like scheduler or something. It has the symbol. So to have some organizing here, I create a new folder for my user where I put all the tasks for my user. Here I create a new task. Let's call it something like monthly backup. And the trigger, as I already said, it shall be once a month. I want it to run in every month. And I want it to run at the first of each month. And I can also pick a time when it shall run. So that's it for the trigger. Then we need to add a new action, and the action is that we want to start a program, and the program or the script we want to start is those script file I just showed you. So now the task is prepared and in place and ready to run, and now I do a little test to see if everything went right. And you see it put me those new archive onto my desktop with the date in the file name. And let's have just a look at it. And you see now all my very important files are in this archive, and the archive is ready to be stored somewhere safely.